What's going on, A Pluses, Nerd Mixers? It is your boy, Indy Uchiha, man. And look, this Hasbro PlusCon 2020 has been off the chain. And I had to tap into what was going on with that Marvel stuff, right? Now, check this out. I am a huge, like, statue collector. Like, I collect a lot of statues, whether Marvel, Star Wars, anime. I do a lot of pops, you know what I'm saying, every now and again, too. But seeing what they're bringing with some of these Hasbro toys that I've never really checked out before, except, I guess, for maybe at the start, some of the Star Wars stuff, because, you know, Hasbro's always been real big on Star Wars toys. Man, looking at some of these replicas, looking at some of these toys, I'm really geeked about what they're doing right now. Like, this Stormbreaker, how big this is, how good this looks, the box art. You know, this is going to be a cosplayer's dream with this Stormbreaker. I got the gauntlet, you know what I'm saying? I got the Finian gauntlet. I got the power glove that Iron Man used. Mjolnir, you know, I got to add Stormbreaker to the collection, right? You got to do it. Who are you if you don't have Stormbreaker? You know, that's the real Thor axe. Like when in the Avengers, when Thor was with Cap, And they switch hammers for a second. He was like, no, you take the little one. I want the big one. I got to get that. They showed us the fan choice, Silk. It's been a lot of rumors, you know what I'm saying, tied around Silk, movie, television series, animated series. So you could really tell that the fans are behind this character. And we should see something happening with her real soon, as we've been talking about on Hero Report. They talked about a Hellfire Club 4-pack from earlier. Now we get to see what the Build-A-Figure is going to be in that Hellfire Club pack, and it's going to be the Hellfire Club Trooper. This has always been one of my favorite minion designs. You know, I was always into putties and stuff like that, so anything that I learned that I love the way the putties look, because I was always influenced by some of the minions and stuff that were in earlier comic books. So this is actually really dope. I'm actually looking forward to building that. Talking about Build-A-Character packs, man, the Build-A-Character for the Marvel line, Joe Fix-It. Yo, that I love Joe Fix-It as a character. It's just something about the Hulk in a suit, you know what I'm saying, being a mob man. It's awesome. But they also showed off some, you know, the Avengers EA gang, which we are streaming on A Plus Opinions over on Twitch. So twitch.tv/A Plus Opinions, where you can catch us streaming the Avengers game. We got to look at Stealth Cap. All black. Look at that. Modeled after the character from the video game. Not Chris Evans from the movie, but the character from the video game. Also, Atmospheric Iron Man. Tell me that suit don't look good. Please tell me that suit don't look good. Marvel also teased, Hasbro also teased 4 figures that were going to be done, you know what I'm saying, off the Marvel line. Before, you had a classic Falcon done by Toy Biz a while back. Hasbro's taking a crack at it. So now you have this Falcon that's being done. Classic costume, striking that pose, man. It looks really, really, really good. First time done by Hasbro in this costume. And then I do believe you had this in a 3-inch figure before, and I think this is the first time it's being done in a 6-inch figure. Kang the Conqueror, with all the news floating around Kang being the showing up in Ant-Man 3, why not take advantage of that and do a 6-inch Kang the Conqueror? This looks amazing. It's probably another buy for me. Then we got the fake Thor Thunderstrike. Does anybody care? I don't. Let's move on. Jocasta, man. Jocasta. Looking all good and all silver. I mean, man, that looks amazing. Some of these figures, they touted some classic X-Men figures like Gambit, Rogue, you know what I'm saying, and all that. I mean, that's cool and all. But I feel like we had them before. Man, this Gambit has a little better grip to hold the staff, to do different poses and stuff like that. But me, I'm never taking them out the box. I got like 3 Gambits. I don't need another one. You know what I'm saying? Then they talked about a Marvel 616 docuseries that's going to be on Disney Plus. The comments got kind of toxic right here. Like, didn't nobody care about that? I care about that because it's going to be going over Hasbro Marvel toys. That's something that seems pretty interesting, seeing the history between Hasbro and Marvel and the different toys. If it goes into why they made some, you know what I'm saying, why they didn't make some, different type of characters and stuff like that. That'd be really cool. I'm looking forward to it. All in all, they show me a lot of stuff that I want. I want that stealth cap. I want the atmospheric Iron Man, Stormbreaker, Silk. I got to get that Kang. Got to get that Falcon. You did to add to the collection. You know, what else? Along with the Power Ranger stuff from earlier. Man, your boy going to be broke. Basically. What was y'all favorite figure they showed off from this panel? And are you looking forward? Do you think Hasbro is living up to the legacy of making good figures? Is there something that you would like them to make that they haven't made yet? Or is there something about some of these, you know what I'm saying, figures that they made that you may not like? Let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, hit that notification bell so you know every time we put up something like this. And as always, you know what it is. It's a Nerd Mix. Keep it A+. We'll be back later with more coverage from Hasbro PulseCon. Indy out.